IMET scientists are developing sustainable practices and technology for aquaculture, or fish farming. Dr. Ten-Tsao Wong works on two big challenges. First, farm fish occasionally escape through the holes in their nets and mate with wild fish in the ocean. This could reduce the genetic diversity of wild fish and impact their ability to survive. Second, fish farmers want to raise fish as quickly as possible to the size that you want on your plate. Dr. Wong has a solution to both problems. We have to create sterile fish. This will help wild populations, aquaculture managers, and people who want to eat healthy fish.
My name is Ten-Tsao Wong. I work at Department of Marine Biotechnology Department at UMBC, also affiliated with IMET. And I'm assistant professor, start from 2016. My current research is very focused on making a reproductive sterile fish for aquaculture. And this is so important because that they help aquaculture to become a sustainable, environmental friendly technology to help farmers to grow fish better. So my research is important because that this technology can help firstly environmental management try to contain these fish to produce a sterile fish. Even if they escape, they were not able to reproduce themselves, they were not able to cross reproduce with wild population to keep that they just live their life in the ocean, and then will not have too much impact genetically in the wild population. Secondly, it's also important because the cost benefit for the farmer. When the fish reach sexual maturity, actually cause a lot of damage to the fish quality, and this is the farmer don't want to see. Basically, our fish, the technology we use is a transient gene silencing technology, which is only work a very short period of time by a compound to block in certain gene expression. That gene is essential for germ cell development, and by doing this, we are just remove some cell from this fish, and this cell is a precursor cell for sperm and egg. Once we remove them, the fish still have a normal all other cell, and they will just not produce the sperm and egg, so they will not reproduce. Our advantage is that we did not change any genetic information in the fish. We are using a transient, a short time period, just removing the germ cell without affecting any genetic background of the fish.